I think they're really retarded, personally.
Why?
Because they make people who aren't a part of certain cliques look less cool, and I think everybody should be the same, or treated the same.
You know, crap like that. People, you know, you have six of them, and then there's one kid that can't sit by you at lunch.
I think they suck. Make kids look bad.
Cliques in school. I don't really think that there really are cliques necessarily, because technically lots of people hang out with one another, like at least in schoolcraft anyway, but I mean, people do have different groups of friends that they do hang out with, but I think everyone has their own little thing that they want to do.
I think they're alright if they're the right kind of clique, but if you get in the wrong kind of clique, like the drug smoking hippie clique, doing cocaine click, that's not good.
I think that there are a lot of them, though most of them are kind of worthless. They try to get people to do stuff that they don't want to do.
What do you think about cliques in school?
I don't like them, unfortunately. There's a lot here at the school. If I could do anything to mix them up, I would, because I think it's very unfortunate when someone's in one clique and they aren't given the opportunity or take the opportunity to meet the other kids in the other clique. I think that's really sad.
Does the school encourage students to celebrate their individuality, or do they prefer the students to fit the preset mold?
They expect them to fit the preset mold. That every kid's perfect and stuff like that.
Why?
Because just what our principal wants from us.
Oh, the preset mold thing. They want them to be together.
If you play football, you're all right, but I mean, if you don't play football, you're pretty much screwed.
I don't think they support it at all. They definitely want people to be the perfect student.
They prefer the students to fit the preset mold.
Why?
Because they put rules like we can't wear hats.
I think they let the kids be somewhat of individuals, but they also have their boundaries because they tell you what you can and cannot wear in school.
Your dress code, sometimes the dress code comes in handy, but sometimes it doesn't.
No, they definitely want you to be a straight-A football player, especially schoolcraft, which is why I'm going to Vicksburg now.
Probably more of a preset mold, because there's a lot of restrictions to what we can wear and what we can't do on lunches. Like, kids that like to skateboard, they can't skateboard out here, but if kids want to play catch football, they can try to play catch football.
Do you think the school supports someone's individuality, or do you think the school wants them to fit the preset mold?
I'd say a little bit of both. This is only my second year here, so I think it's unfortunate that we don't have all the sports that the area schools offer, and I think there is a way that we could have that.
Does the school favor the athletic type over someone who doesn't participate in sports?
Yes.
Why?
Because I'm in the drama club and choir and band, and we don't get the same kind of stuff as the athletic people do.
Yes.
Why?
Because they participate in a sport, therefore they represent the school according to our principal, therefore they're worth more.
Oh yeah, but we have some football player with jersey on smoking a cigarette out in the parking lot, and we have like little Jake on a skateboard, and we'll just come up to him and yell at him.
Definitely. I think kids that do sports get a lot more credit than kids that don't do it.
Oh yeah, they love the football players and the baseball players. As long as you play a sport, you don't get in any trouble.
And the superintendent one day come up to us because we were skateboarding in the parking lot and said skateboarding was bad judgment. Who's he say skateboarding's a bad judgment?
I don't think so, because most of the school is mostly academics come first. I mean, I love sports and everything, but first has to come academics and then athletics.
Yeah, they do. An example of that is that the football players this year, they were doing really good. Everyone thought that they were going to get to state again. But the second game of the playoffs, I was told that they drank and they partied, and the coaches knew this, and they were able to go through the whole thing and not get in trouble, even though they lost. Hello?
Yes, I do. I think they get treated a lot better.
This school is really all about football, in case you didn't know. But we really focus on football here, and a lot of money goes to football. And I think if we could just take a little bit of the money away from that program and put it towards other programs, I think that would make for more of a well-rounded student. I mean, if there's more things to offer, the more they'll become, more worldly.
What did Cliques do to someone's self-esteem in life?
I think that maybe their self-esteem does go up, but then in the real world, when they're not within that clique, I think that their self-esteem goes down because they're not in that comfort zone, and that comfort zone is not realistic.